And we're back with another episode of the Manstream Podcast, the Masters Edition, as was put on YouTube and Facebook. It is Masters time. Mm-hmm. We have Dave, Josh, and Mike tonight. How we doing, fellas?
The three amigos are here.
The three amigos.
Tres amigos.
Three musketeers.
Musketeers.
It's no. Masters week, man.
It is Masters
week. I'm excited. I'm pumped. It's my favorite time of the year.
It is my favorite time of the year as well. Baseball season's underway. Birds are chirping. Getting nicer out. Green grass.
Windows open.
This is the beginning of the best times of year from Agreed. April until, like, mm-hmm. we'll say early December, because you got to get Thanksgiving in there and football and stuff. So yeah. That's probably, I think, a fair.
Yeah.
I think we all enjoy fall and summer. Winter some days, but
never.
It just depends how much snow there is, I guess.
Never. No. I think a lot of it, I mean, I have different multiple favorite times of the year, like when football's going on, hockey starts, basketball starts, and then now March Madness just got over, baseball started.
Mm-hmm.
It's getting nice out, you know. So
bonfire season is one of my favorite.
Season, racing season starts.
Yeah. Oh yeah,
go Ryan.
Yeah, Ryan.
Excited for you, buddy.
He's racing tonight in his first race. Yep. So if we get an update while we're live, we'll let you know how Ryan did.
Yeah. Do you know what time he started tonight?
6:30.
Okay.
Something like that.
All right. And where's he at tonight? Is he down in Muscatine or
no? Moline or Davenport.
Oh, okay.
So I think Davenport. I think Moline's on Sunday nights.
I tell you, we got to be the pit crew when it hits Maquoketa.
He doesn't like racing Maquoketa.
Oh, he doesn't? Mm.
I think I've heard him say that too. So I don't know if it's just because the track or something. Is it dirt or something? Or
well, it's all dirt.
Oh, I didn't know. I didn't know if they do like speedways and stuff.
I'm not a race fan.
When I think racing, I think NASCAR. I'm sorry. You think
pavement?
I do, honestly. Yeah. I think NASCAR. And it's
or
no,
F1.
No disrespect to anybody who does dirt racing. I do enjoy dirt racing when I go to the fair and stuff. But
yeah,
no, it's 100% dirt track. For Ryan. Ryan doesn't do any hard surface,
like rally cars.
Similar.
No, I mean,
but in a circle.
Stock car.
Yeah.
In a circle.
I think he's sport.
In a circle.
I've seen it before.
I think he's sport mod.
Is he?
I think so. He's not late mod.
Not hobby stock.
Not hobby stock either. I think sport mod's where he's at. New car this year, completely redone.
Still, I like the colors.
Still the 69er. Mm-hmm. He got rid of the pink and went red. So.
And we got a logo on there.
And we have our logo on there. Yeah, look at that. We didn't even have to pay a sponsorship fee.
It's beautiful. We shouldn't say that.
It's not what you know. It's what you know.
We didn't have to pay a sponsorship fee.
Nominal. Nominal value.
Nominal fee.
No, it's a good time of year, man.
Yeah.
It is a really good time of year.
It is.
The Masters have been great so far. Have you guys been watching it all?
Yes, it's windier than hell today.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't catch the end of the leaderboard, but I think Bryson was ahead yesterday, 7-under.
I think they're all minus six. Scheffler, DeChambeau, Scheffler and Homa.
Scotty was tied.
Yep. Homa, DeChambeau, and Scheffler all tied at minus six.
Minus six.
Max Homa.
Yeah. Max Homa.
He's shooting good. I mean, I watched DeChambeau tee off on, was it this morning, I think?
You say that name funny.
DeChambeau?
DeChambeau.
DeChambeau.
I don't know how do you pronounce
Bryson
it.
Bryson DeChambeau.
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 I'm not French. I'm sorry if I butcher someone's last name.
That's like an Austin and Austin.
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 Yeah.
People do
like
that
otter?
All the time. Yeah, like.
That's an O.
Like milk. Milk.
Oh, dude, I hate it when people
Warsh.
Say
Warsh. Pillow.
Yeah.
Pillow.
I pillow.
Pillow. I'm going to go sleep on my pillow.
I'm going to go drawl. What are you drawling on?
You know, one thing I hate, like around here, the Germans. Use guys.
Utes guys. Utes guys.
Whatever the fuck it
that's
is.
That's the Green Island thing.
Is it really?
Oh, yeah, dude. Them guys down in Green Island. Utes guys.
Them guys. Them guys.
Yeah. It caught me off guard. I was like, what? And where I work, dealing with the people, a lot of them say Utes guys.
Utes guys. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's interesting,
to
say the least.
What's the other one that they do all the time? They'll be saying something. They'll be like, "Well, like as I was saying," and I'm like, "You never said nothing before." Yeah. That. So, or as I said,
well, like I said. Like I said,
yeah,
like you ain't I said, shit. No,
dude, you didn't say nothing. Like I didn't hear you say anything. like I was saying, you would win. So the Masters. It's Tiger made the cut.
Yeah, he's always a big name. I mean,
Tiger made the cut. He was plus two.
Isn't this the record now for him?
Yeah,
24.
Making the most cuts.
Yeah. I just saw that. Yeah, 24.
Yeah.
So good for him. Good for Tiger.
Dude,
I mean,
he came out looking like he was fucking ripped. Like hit that test and whatever he
I think
needed to be.
That was his problem, though. Like, wasn't it because he got bigger that he started swinging?
Yeah, I think that's a lot. My personal opinion, I think that's a lot of their problems. Rory McIlroy went on that same thing.
Yeah, and he got big up, and he couldn't. And his swing got messed up.
Where's he been?
Yeah. He can crush the ball, but
DeChambeau had a plan. It was a
he says it the same way I do.
Yeah, DeChambeau.
I love
DeChambeau.
It.
DeChambeau. I follow him on YouTube, and he said that he had a plan, like a 4-year plan, to bulk up, kind of like a power lifter would, or somebody who's in like a figure competition, and then he was going to cut heavily because he wanted to get the bulk, and he wanted to get his distance, and then he wanted to cut so he could get more of the rotation down.
Well, he does a lot of the long drive competitions.
Oh, dude can fucking crush it.
So Bryson DeChambeau is the only one, well, now he's in LIV, but was in the PGA Tour. He's the only one. All of his clubs are the same length.
Yeah.
Irons. I mean, if you're familiar with golf, like I am, and I know Josh is, and Dave's somewhat familiar with playing the golf. playing the golf. Normally, your wedges are shorter, 60, 56 pitching wedge, mm-hmm. you know, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4 for irons, mm-hmm. and then your five wood, 3 wood, and driver are all different. Bryson DeChambeau's are same across the board.
He has
a theory that my swing will never change, and in theory, he's correct, but he's the only one who does it.
Yeah.
When we were at the John Deere Classic the 1 year. I don't remember what hole we got on. Normally, I would go sit on 16.
That's the best
I'd start off at 1, and then I'd walk through, get a pork chop sandwich, sit on 16.
Yeah.
I think we're on like 4. It was Zach Johnson, Bryson DeChambeau, and I can't remember who else. And they were like in awe looking at his clubs going, dude, this just doesn't make sense. You know, I heard Zach Johnson go, this is just crazy. But
he's breaking barriers, I guess, in the PGA.
Dude has the longest drive.
And whatever works for you, too, like in the end, if you're comfortable with your equipment, you know, that just goes, that's a benefit to you, right?
But the thing about it was, is when he first came on, he was tearing it up, and he had regular standard clubs. Like obviously they were fitted for him, but he wasn't going all single length Cobras like he has now. And I thought he was doing very well because he made it and was winning tournaments, and then all of a sudden decided he wanted more power and more distance.
Right. So, right. Well,
and he took some shit for years for it.
Oh, big time. And he still takes some shit for the clothesline incident. Mm-hmm. Do you remember that? He went to walk under that line and it hit him in the top of the head and he acted like it choked him out.
Oh, yeah.
Bryson DeChambeau.
That's like the LeBron James flop.
It is.
My eyelash.
It is.
Yeah.
My eyelash?
Yeah. Yeah, he said he got poked in the eye and somebody said it was just a brush of an eyelash and he fucking flopped and fell over and acted like he was dying.
That doesn't surprise me.
Yeah, he's not the GOAT.
That's a lot of the NBA, I feel like. It's just about drawing contact and any sports in general. I'm not just going to throw the NBA into the bus.
LeBron James and James Harden are by far the worst.
Absolutely. James Harden was always looking for contact on that. Like, he'd drive into you, then pop back.
Oh, man, if you touched
it pissed me off the way he played.
If you touched one beard hair on him, he was down.
Yeah, he was fouled.
Not to talk too much about sports, but I think it's hilarious that Bronny James has announced he's going to the NBA draft.
Yeah.
Bronny James averaged 4 points a game for USC this year.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you why. You know why? Is because wherever he goes,
his daddy's going to go.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then his daddy's going to retire.
It's a story for the
NBA.
I
guarantee LeBron is trying to figure out how to tell, like, the Lakers, I will pay you this much to trade up to draft him.
Ooh, probably. Or he'll pay for it out of his own salary.
Absolutely. Huh. Just to play with him to say he did.
Just
Has there ever been an NBA duo, father-son, play together?
No, that's probably why he wants to. Maybe not. Maybe not I.
I don't think there has been.
I don't think so either, but that's a good question. Has there ever been a duo of a father-son playing together in any sport?
Moses Malone? Yeah.
Ken Griffey Jr.
and Senior.
Did they play on the same team?
Yeah, they hit a home run back-to-back, I'm pretty sure. Yeah.
Okay. Number 3, number 4.
There's been a lot of them, I feel like. I think the Niekro brothers actually played together. Niekro, the pitchers.
Niekro?
I think Phil Niekro and...
Niekro.
I don't... Was that...
Yeah, you don't. He's a knuckleballer for the Yankees.
But wasn't it N-E-G-R-O?
No, N-I-E-K-R-O.
Was it?
Niekro. Yeah, Phil Niekro.
Are you trying to get him to say something?
No.
And he shouldn't?
Spell
it out.
N-I-E-K-R-O, Phil Niekro. He's a Hall of Fame pitcher. He's a knuckleballer.
I thought it was like, spelled the other way.
But him and his brother played. There's been a lot of like father-son.
Or N-E-K-R-O. Oh, brother.
It's N-I-E-K-R-O. Oh, N-I-E,
sorry, what did I say? N-E-I?
You said
I comes before E, except after C.
Yeah, except in English, too.
Oh.
That's crazy.
I've gone. Yeah, apparently, I've been pronouncing his name wrong my entire life.
Yeah. Teach their own.
Yeah. Absolutely. Leave it at that. So, yeah. Yeah, it is golf season, Masters edition. We don't want to talk too much on that, but
it is Masters edition, though, so we can talk as much as we want about the Masters, because the Masters is awesome to watch. And golf and this stuff is fun. Very fun to play. I enjoyed it. It's relaxing, and it's very stress relieving. So I enjoy it, but
I agree. I love golf.
We should just go do that right now. Just go golfing.
We're done.
We're just gonna go. Just go do
Henry, do not cut.
just follow us.
So we'll go golf.
Speaking of Masters Edition, we have a Masters drink for our Sip and Saver segment, sponsored by Van's Liquor Store in East Dubuque, Illinois. This drink is called the Azalea.
Absolutely.
It is a big drink down at Augusta National. And it came around because of the azaleas at the Masters on Augusta National.
Amen Corner.
Iggy Azalea?
Amen Corner. Yeah, no, the Azalea Flower.
Azalea Flower.
and Iggy? I think, you know, obviously it gets its color for the Azalea Flowers.
Yeah.
So it is vodka, grenadine, pineapple juice, and lemon juice?
Yeah, yeah. If you want to make your own, it's 2 ounces of vodka. We left the bottle up there. Grey Goose from Van's Liquor. 2 ounces of pineapple juice, 1 ounce of lemon juice, splash of grenadine, and garnish with a lemon.
A lemon pinwheel.
And you got to drink it with a finger out.
it's delicious, man.
It is really good. It's really fruity.
Honestly, it tastes like the kids' juice boxes, and that's scary.
Yeah, Josh didn't measure 2 ounces of anything. He just dumped
in. I did too,
man. He was using his fingers.
I was a professional bartender for 10 years.
It tastes a little salty.
Yeah.
You too?
That was the cup I did that in last week.
Oh, nice.
No, there should be no salt in it, man.
Mine tastes a little
a little moldy.
Well, when you guys don't clean shit up, what do you expect?
Oh.
Now it's our fault.
Oh, part of the ship, part of the crew.
It was Dave. He didn't show up late. Or he didn't show up last time to clean. Well, we're going to blame him, right?
I mean, it's tasty. I'm just curious on the salt flavor at the end.
Let me taste it.
I think we all know where.
Did you put your dip of chew in or what?
No.
There should be no salt in it at all.
Yeah, it is.
Maybe there's salt in the pineapple juice.
I don't think so. Yeah, mine wasn't salty at all, but I don't know what you're tasting. Did you put like pickle juice in that or something?
Yours is salty too?
No.
Oh. Maybe Dave dumped some of that red powder in
the tahine?
The tahine.
You wouldn't taste salt out of that.
No.
I don't know. It's good.
I enjoy it.
It definitely is good. So, yeah, stop on over to Van's Liquor Store. Get yourself a bottle of Grey Goose. Buy some grenadine while you're there. Do they sell lemons?
You know, they don't, man. Okay. I had to go to a grocery store.
Go to a grocery store to get a lemon.
Yep.
Wherever that local grocery store may be. And do they sell pineapple juice at Van's?
They do.
Yeah, they do. So
they do.
Go over there, get your pineapple juice. Tell them the Mainstream Podcast sent you. And maybe they'll give you a discount. Who knows? But just tell them that so they know that...
We're funneling people through the door.
Funneling people through the door.
You fuckers are listening.
Yeah, so we're going to jump to our Van's Liquor sponsor ad, and we'll be right back in a second.
Are you ready to make every moment unforgettable? Well, we've got the perfect pit stop for you. Van's Liquor. Need a rare bottle for that special occasion? Van's Liquor has it. Craving the finest beers for your weekend hangout? Van's Liquor has it. Just over the bridge at 470 Cincinnati Avenue, East Dubuque. Van's Liquor has everything you need to turn the ordinary into extraordinary. Don't settle for less. Choose the best at Van's Liquor, your celebration headquarters in East Dubuque.
Thank you for the sponsor, Van's Liquor. And like I said, if you need any beverage needs, head on over to Van's Liquor in East Dubuque, Illinois. Get yourself, they have a wide selection, and specials change weekly. So head on over and get yourself something.
Yeah, and again, they do match all prices in the tri-state area, so you
find... I always forget that.
Yeah, well, I think it's cool. Like, there's not a lot of... like, Best Buy does it, right? Mm-hmm. If you find somebody else's ad, Best Buy will match the price, or is that Walmart?
That's a lot of places. I haven't been in Best Buy in years, though.
But there's not a lot of places that match liquor prices, so if you find something on sale, take it over to Van, show them the ad, they'll give you the same price there.
Or do people still go to Best Buy?
I'm not. I guess I don't.
If I need a cable and I can't wait for Amazon to get it here, yeah, for sure.
Amazon's like a day, 2 days.
I know. It just depends, man. Where it's at.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know. I haven't been enough.
You're the reason why stores are dying.
Me?
Whomever. Whoever doesn't use the stores. I don't go to Best Buy either.
I don't go to Best Buy, but you're like, the reason why.
I am part of the reason because Amazon's so So easy.
So just easy, and it's cheaper.
Sometimes.
Dude, Best Buy is outrageous.
Yeah,
Best Buy
is outrageous. Sometimes Amazon's overpriced if you're not searching for the right stuff.
Well, that's why you
it's anything is. If you get taken advantage of, I mean.
Yeah, if you go to a bad drug dealer, I'm sure that cocaine you bought is probably more expensive than if you went to a good one.
Yeah.
I wouldn't know. I'm just saying.
I have heard. Mike's encounter. Can I have one drugs, please?
One drugs, please. I need one drugs,
I would like one drugs, please. And make that snappy, sir.
Did you guys see that Theo Von interview that he had with Tucker Carlson? He's like, man, I used to do cocaine. Problem is, can't find any good shit anymore. It's all cut with fentanyl. And Tucker Carlson goes, yeah, it used to be cut with baby powder back in the day. Or not baby powder, baby formula or some shit like that. And he's like, Theo goes, yeah, man. He's like, I get hungry when I'm snorting some coke, but man, you do that new shit. He's like, you'll end up in a box dead, turning blue. He's like, yeah, you really can't do much if you're sitting in the fucking coffin. I tell you what, some of the cocaine stories that guy's had,
yeah,
it's crazy.
It's a bad deal. I always joke with saying that if I ever wanted to go to the dispensary, I probably couldn't do it because of the wide variety of, like, it looks like a McDonald's board up there. I was told, dude. It's like, dude, what do you even buy?
You were told.
I was told.
I've never been there.
My God, there's like 10 TVs in that fucking place, and they are literally zipping through, like, edibles and chocolate bars and drinks and pens and flowers.
Just a party zone of just flashing lights and disco balls everywhere.
It's
everything you guys would think it is in a stoner's paradise. Just everything.
It's Disney World to a stoner.
As I was informed by someone I know, no, don't look that way. It's not him. That everything is different now when it comes to it, like strains and everything. That is not what it used to be back in the day.
Yeah, it's not the old ditch weed.
Yeah.
I don't know.
growing up in Adair, my dad, we'd fucking gravel travel, and he's like, hey, there's a plant, go pick it. We'll dry that shit out. And I'm like,
Dave's looking like, I don't know.
I don't even know.
You're going to smoke that shit? He's like, that's ditch weed, son. That's good stuff.
Shit'll give you a headache.
He does know.
I imagine. I had heard.
This one guy told me once.
Yes, one drugs,
anyways,
please.
So one drugs, please. Yeah, so drugs.
What's your favorite?
I don't know.
I like a good NyQuil. Just when I'm feeling sick, give me some sleep.
Yeah. Robitussin, Robibon?
No, absolutely not. Don't make me gag, dude. I had something. I don't want to product shame, so no, I'm not going to say it. Something the other day that was
sponsored by anybody.
Coca-Cola spiced is ass. I'm just saying it.
Coca-Cola what?
Spiced is ass.
What is that?
Yeah.
You haven't seen, so Coca-Cola came out with a new flavor. It's spice. It's like
with what? Nutmeg?
Robitussin it tastes like.
It tastes like Robitussin.
I am not kidding. Robitussin mixed with like root beer.
Like a clove.
Who mixes Robitussin with root beer?
Coca-Cola does to make Coca-Cola spiced. I'm just saying it was the nastiest thing I ever had. It made me like almost want to throw up.
It's like the scissor, huh?
I mean, it wasn't like the scissor, I guess.
Isn't scissor like Robitussin and grape juice?
I don't know.
No, it's like Sprite.
Fresca and Sprite mixed with like...
Robitussin?
No.
Dramamine?
No, not... No.
Robitussin's not involved?
No, it's like codeine.
Oh, I think it is codeine, yeah.
That's bad stuff.
Yeah, like that is bad lean, stuff. Lean.
Do you have to say it with one eye closed?
My cheeks fucking close an eye when I say lean. It's a problem with being fat, Mike.
I'm like, why are you trying to be a pirate over there? Lean.
Oh, dude, we were getting professional pictures taken for work, and the guy's like, hey, smile. And I'm like, no. Like, you ain't going to see my eyes. He's like, are you stoned, sir? And I said, no, absolutely not. I'm like, I'm a ginger, and I'm fucking frail, and my eyes don't really open.
And I'm loyal in Hawaii.
I can't see the sun too good.
Well, I mean, if I try to open my eyes and look, it's like
my retinas will get sunburned.
I'll look at the camera and do it. You guys are gonna fucking laugh. It's like I gotta go like this to open them up, otherwise they don't fucking open.
You get sunburned on the whites of your eyes when you look at the sun for too long.
Dude, I get sunburnt sitting in a car driving somewhere.
That lemon pinwheel on your glass probably is sunburning you with the reflection off the light.
These fucking lights are sunburned. Every time I get out of here, next day my face is red.
He's got third degree boils on his underarms.
Boils don't.
No, you've had them though. You have had those before, haven't you?
A boil?
Not a boil. The third degree burns on your, or the burns on your.
Yeah, my ankles.
From sunburn. Your ankles.
I went to Australia and we took a vacation on the way back in Hawaii for a week, and I went snorkeling, and it was like midsummer, so it was 105 degrees, whatever it was. Pure sun, no shade.
In where?
Hawaii, Honolulu.
Yeah.
And we went to Hanama Bay, and it was so hot you couldn't walk on the sand without putting socks and shoes on. You couldn't even wear flip flops because like the sand would just burn your skin. So I went out there. had a buddy like spray my back down. I rubbed everything up. We got in to go snorkeling, and I fucking got in and took my tube socks off back in 2000. I forgot to fucking put it on the legs on the tube socks, and I was snorkeling for 5 hours, came out, didn't feel anything. But, like, after a while, that water washes all that sunscreen away off your back, too. And I fucking, next day, I woke up with blisters everywhere.
Didn't you get burns on you from a TV exploding in a wood pile or a burn pile?
No, that was plastic.
Plastic. That was plastic. Like, bottles that you decided to leave the caps on. Like a dumbass, but you know what?
No, it wasn't. It was plastic bags.
You keep looking at your arm like it's still there.
It is. You see burn right there.
Oh, yeah.
You can see burns up here. Oh. But yeah, it was plastic bags that we used for sandbags. And we emptied the sand out of them. We burnt basically it was like Tyvek. And it was at the bottom of the burn pile. And I threw a log on it, and all that plastic blew up on me.
Hmm.
Wasn't good. No bueno.
So what'd you learn?
Not
it
to throw
sounded
shit
like that. It was stuck to
don't,
the...
Not don't throw big logs on molten plastic.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Yeah. Was,
well, were you moving out then?
Semi moving out. It was like the month ahead of it.
That was before we had this lovely studio.
Beautiful setup, yeah.
Now here we are.
And now here we are in the studio.
Empty drinks.
Mine's not empty.
Here you go. Finish mine if you want.
You don't like it?
No, it's not. It's fine.
Oh, you just want the Diet Dr. Pepper, huh?
Yeah.
You got some of the salt?
No, I'm good. Feels like I'm on the beach. Got a little salt water in the air.
Got a little sun on you. A little
tequila
salt.
Licking it.
Yeah. So, some sadder deal. The Iowa Hawkeye girls are done. Not necessarily sad that they lost.
Bittersweet.
Sad that
it's over.
It's over.
It's over. What a hell of a run! Just the last 4 years in general. I mean, for Iowa has been really special. I feel like a lot of people have tuned in and like gravitated towards this team. Just because of what they've been able to accomplish and like what they've meant to the state as a whole, I feel like. And Iowa State, too. I don't want to just say that Iowa was great, but they were both good. But Iowa was way, like, they had Caitlin Clark, let's be honest. So it was good to see her go to the championship game. Wish we could have won it. But in the end, the girls played really great this year. I did not expect them to go to the championship game. I thought that they had lost too much in the offseason and switching Stilkey to the 5. I thought it would hurt them. But they showed me wrong, and I am...
We lost two people.
Who?
We lost Monica Sinano and McKenna Warnock. That was it.
Yeah, but they were two, pretty big contributors.
Oh, yeah, I mean, two starters.
Yeah. McKenna could have came back, but she did leave. So Caitlin could have came back, too.
School.
I tell you what. There's always time for that, though.
If Sinano was there, I don't know, man. Would have been a different game.
Well, yeah, they would have had two
bigger
posts.
Would have had at least a big against their big, big.
Sinano was 6'2", 6'3", right? On the same size as
Stalky.
Stalky. But a little just better.
She played bigger.
Yeah, she played bigger.
She did, but she also.
Better footwork and then very good under the rim. Like, she was not a misser at all.
Yeah, I also felt like she and Caitlin had a better, I don't know.
That bond between.
Yeah, teammate, like a friendship. But
the bond between Stalky picked up to the end of this.
It did.
Very well,
I think. The difference was. Monica Sinano had hands like glue.
Yeah. She didn't drop anything. And a lot of the girls this year missed.
Any ball that was whipped into her by Caitlin, she got. She didn't miss. So, and that came from playing with her for three years before that.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm gonna give a shout out. I know Ryan's a shout out guy. I'm going to give a shout out to the WNBA players that just can't be happy for the fact that their game is getting boosted and want to talk a bunch of fucking shit.
Yeah.
It's annoying. Yeah. Shut up.
Yeah.
I mean,
it is annoying. I don't like the tear down aspect of it. Like, why not use this and ride this momentum and take advantage of it? Not only money wise, but just overall exposure wise. Like, you are finally able to get this platform, and you're choosing to be spiteful about it because someone doesn't fit the status quo of what you think your brand should be in the WNBA. And I feel like Caitlin is a threat to that. Because of how dynamic her personality is. One, she's very, I don't want to say cocky, but very confident.
She's got a chip on her shoulder.
Yeah, that's it. She feels like she's got a chip on her shoulder always. And she always comes through in the clutch. Like, and people don't like that, I think.
It's not even that. Like, Diana Taurasi's talking out of her ass. Sue Bird's talking out of her ass. Sue Bird was actually the one didn't really talk that much. Brianna Stewart, them UConn babies.
Yeah, that was...
You know, they played in the NCAA when there was no competition. everybody was on UConn. If you wanted to win, you went to UConn in Tennessee, or maybe Stanford when Tara Vanderveer was still
coaching.
Who she retired, by the way. Shut up. She puts asses in seats.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to make you more money.
She's selling the brand. Like, what more could you want?
I was so they put a, like 1,000 tickets, I think, for sale out for the WNBA draft on Monday, and they sold out within like 5 minutes. And I'm pretty sure that has never happened before.
And that's the arrogance to not admit who your golden goose is just blows my mind.
The Indiana Fever was nationally televised one game last year. They're now scheduled to be nationally televised for 36 this year, and they haven't even drafted her.
I don't understand it. Like, yeah, it bugs me too, because we all see the numbers. We see the do people just not want to admit what the reason is? Like, what's the harm in saying
they're jealous?
Exactly.
Is what it is.
It's women on women. As Dave Portnoy says, it's women on women hate. And everybody that I talk to, and there's a lot of women that I talk to, most of them say women are that way. Women are mean to each other.
Yeah.
Like, worse than men. Like, I may tell you to go fuck yourself. Pardon how I said that, but I may tell you that.
I'm just going to go do it.
Or I'm joking. Or even if it was serious, you and I would turn around the next day and be like, hey, man.
We're okay.
We're okay. You know,
wiener to wiener hug.
And that's, yeah.
Good. this feels right.
And that's not how it works with
sometimes
the other gender. And I'm not ripping on them, but they are mean to each other.
I think people in general are just mean. Like, and I think we see it a lot more because of social media. People can hide behind that keyboard. But I think that there's an overall meanness that people just want to be bitter for. And I'm guilty of it. I think we're all guilty of it, but... They just want to hate. People just want to hate, and we're all guilty of it. But like, some of this is next level stuff. Like, some people have to delete their social media accounts because there's threats against them. Like
Gabby.
Yeah. What the fuck? Like, it's a game, guys. It's a game.
Okay. So let's touch on that for a second, because I read an article today where Aaliyah Edwards. She made a statement after the game that she was never given any sort of. Reasoning on why that was called, and she said the hate is real, meaning I don't even have to say it, you should know what that means because of what people have made this game about, the R word.
Yeah.
And what hate? Racism.
Ronaldo.
Ronaldo.
Oh, I thought
Ronaldo.
You were talking about soccer.
Rum bum.
Somebody said, is that a Chinese finger trap?
Those things, man. Have you ever used... do you remember them things?
Yeah. You ever put them on all four of your fingers and try to...
One. No, I got locked into one like the Adams Family.
Put them on all four and try to get them out.
A lot of times, once I get them on there, like I literally just rip the thing because I can't get it off.
Did your fingers...
Yeah, I don't know how to do
that. You're just so yoked.
Yeah. But anyways, if you don't understand why that wasn't called... Like, why that was called... I question you. Like, that is the most blatant, obvious.
She shuffled her hips into her
book on what a illegal screen is.
Yeah.
They're just going to chalk it up to it's the end of the game. Let them play.
But that's not. So, okay. So,
when do you call a foul then?
So, with 2 minutes to go, the ref should just go to the locker room. Let them duke it out.
Yeah.
That's, like,
I know, but that was their argument.
I know, but it's still. Like, that's a terrible argument. When do you call a foul? A foul is a foul no matter what time it is.
Do you remember
start to finish?
Was it 2 years ago when Iowa was playing Indiana? And Caitlin Clark hit that buzzer shot to end the season and to
win the Big Ten championship.
Yeah, regular season.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Monica Sinano was called for that foul on Holmes with like 1.2 seconds to go at the free throw line, and she really didn't even foul her, but she was, you know, they said it was body bump.
I mean, don't remember that. I remember the shot.
That was a bad call, you know, because she traveled before it. Then it was just a little bit of body contact, but when it's a blatant foul.
Oh, yeah.
If you went up, if I was going up for a layup with 5 seconds to go and Dave jumped up and he didn't get the ball, but he hit my arm, I would expect that to be called.
Mm-hmm.
And to say, well, no, you can't call that because it's the end of the game. You just can't. That's asinine.
Yeah.
That is stupid. You don't understand sports.
I guess my thought was why were they playing? Why was UConn playing for the three when they were only down by one?
Oh, I don't think they were actually playing for the three.
You think they were just trying to get an opening on the inside?
Well, okay. They were trying to. So let's be honest. So Paige Buechers was the one who messed that play up.
Yeah.
She left way too much room between Aaliyah Edwards And when she was coming around, because when you're coming around and someone's going to sit a screen, you want to brush
rub
shoulders
right off them,
so that way there's no room for the defender to get through.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And Paige Buechers came around wide and left enough room for
Gabby to sneak
you to get through.
It's a fucking highway.
And so imagine little Gabby Marshall. So
imagine little Gabby Marshall.
Yeah,
she's so tiny.
Right, she slipped right
so
through.
Small.
When
she just
you
stuck
have
right
to
through.
Spread your legs and almost do the splits. I mean, the rule states that you can't. Your legs have to be parallel with your shoulders or closed.
They were spread out. Yeah, she was.
They were spread out.
And she moved. She
and
was
she
moving.
She moved
she
her shoulder.
Moving into
so,
her. Like,
I just, you know what? At the end of the day, shut up. Be happy that your sport is getting the notoriety that it's supposed to. Because just before that, the practice for Team USA, an interviewer said to Diana Taurasi and Kelsey Plume, "What do you think about the attention the women's basketball is getting? It's about damn time. If you keep running your mouth, that is going to be done in a year or two. Nobody's going to follow it again."
Yeah, I agree.
As a national level, you're going to have your Iowa that always follows women's sports. As a national level, people are going to get so tired of the hate, they're just going to drop off. They're not going to watch it.
So I hope it doesn't continue.
So,
but
shut your mouth and be happy that someone has done what they've done, and it has nothing to do with race. It has nothing to do with – it has to do
talent,
with great,
pure
greatness.
Talent, pure greatness,
and
pure basketball.
What they've done – how they've grabbed the young kids and changed people's lives. I mean, just the way that the people
the
look at the
inspiration that has been drawn
absolutely.
From this
absolutely and
has been profound. I feel like for not only our state, but
besides every now and then whining to a ref, Caitlin Clark has always been a very well spoke. Good, like throwing out, like, "Hey, great for my teammates."
Yeah,
I couldn't do it without them.
Very humble, about
very stand up to what she does, and so I don't understand the hate, but I had to get that off my chest. My shoulders are lighter now.
Good,
are they?
Good.
Yeah. So shut up. Anyways, so we're gonna take a quick Deary Nissan break here. Deary Nissan of Dubuque sponsors us. Go see them for any oil changes. Vehicle purchases.
I just got my oil change this week. Tell you what, service. Pulled up half an hour before my appointment. Shuttle was ready to take me back to work, and they dropped my car off pretty much on time.
Yeah. Did they smile the whole time?
You know, the guy was really nice.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
They're good. So, quick word from Deary Nissan, and we'll be back with the Manstream Podcast Draft.
Ooh, I'm excited.
Yeah, I don't know too. Why I said that so funny. The Manstream Podcast Draft. Take it away, Deary Nissan.
Hello, I'm Chad Waters, General Manager of Deary Brothers Nissan, and I invite you to come experience the difference a dealer can make. We're offering a whole new way of doing business centered around a total customer service experience. From pre-sale to post-sale, our team will be with you every step of the way. Be sure to check out our Deary Certified Program, including our 3,000-mile warranty. So come experience the difference a dealer can make at Deary Brothers Nissan.
Thank you, Deary Nissan. For any vehicle needs, go see Deary Nissan. Oil changes, service, new vehicle purchase, used vehicle purchase. Go see them in Dubuque, Iowa. Nissan brand new, BMW brand new.
They finally got rid of that GTR that was up there.
Yeah.
Yeah, some lawyer from Minneapolis came down and traded an Audi R7.
An Audi or an Innie?
Audi.
An Audi. When I worked there, I sold a brand new GTR.
Did you really?
Yeah, I took in a trade. It was a guy, I don't remember what he did. He was some big wig. It's John Deere, then retired, lived out in Apple River. Traded in a 2010 GTR on a brand new one. And his 2010 had some special packages in it.
Cool.
Had a lot of horsepower. Mark Simmons, a salesman there, sold the one the year before I sold that one, sold a blue one that was taken and had the Godzilla package in that put over 1,000 horsepower in it. And that dude ran the Route 66 rally with it and sent us videos going 200 some miles an hour.
Damn.
That's nuts.
GTRs are fun. They are fun. They were, when I was selling cars, they were the fastest performance car, or fastest production car made.
Nice.
They would
what?
Do 0 to 60 in 2.7
the
seconds.
The Bugatti?
That's not production.
Oh.
Production means they make multiple.
Gotcha.
Not special order.
Okay, mm-hmm. Not one of
so, them. And the GTRs were made, they were like made in a contaminated free room, like sheets up, like hand put together for
very
that
specific, precise, very precise. Clean and stuff.
Yep. GTRs are pretty fun.
I like GTRs.
All-wheel drive.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would love to have one, be able to drive one, but
yeah, brand new.
I'd take
like
an older one. I'd take an older one though. Probably like the Skyline GTR is what I'd like to have.
So I looked it up. Koenigsegg.
Who?
The Absolute Koenigsegg.
Absolute Vodka.
No, Koenigsegg Absolute.
Koenig.
Now Koenigsegg. Koenigsegg.
Koenigsegg.
Yeah, that guy right there. The fastest production car now with a top calculated target of 310 miles an hour.
That's liftoff. That's liftoff.
That's fucking insane.
I've never even heard of it.
Yeah.
Koenigsegg? They're fast. They're like supercars.
Dave knows that because of
Forza.
Forza.
Absolutely. Yeah. I don't care. It's still.
Wasn't it that Need for Speed movie they redid with
No, they didn't have a Koenigsegg. They had Lamborghinis. They had, oh my gosh.
No, they had Koenigseggs.
No, they didn't. They had Lamborghinis.
What was that movie?
The one guy had a Koenigsegg. So they did. There was Koenigseggs were in that
sound
movie.
Sound like you're saying Koenigsegg.
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 Koenigsegg. S E G G G. There's like three G's at the end of
see
it.
See that? It's like, was it Swedish or Dutch or something like
I think
that?
I don't know. I don't know where it's from. German, I would assume.
Koenigsegg. Koenigshead.
Whatever it is. But yeah, in that movie, there was Lamborghinis. I don't know if it wasn't a Diablo. It was I can't think of the name of it, but
Diablo.
Lamborghinis are sweet cars too.
The Aventador.
I don't think it was an Aventador.
I'm gonna call myself El Diablo.
That was a good
That's
move.
That's awesome. What's that mean?
You know what I'm talking about?
A Spanish fighting
they
chicken.
They had three Koenigseggs. I thought. Oh yeah, Koenigsegg Jägeras.
That might have been the.
Remember the three where that guy died off the bridge?
Yeah, I know that. I don't think that was. It might have been.
Yeah.
You might be right, yeah. But I know at the end it was Lamborghinis they were using. So, anyways.
Draft time.
It is draft time.
I think we got a good one tonight.
You're the magic man, and I'm El Diablo.
What's El Diablo? I think it's like Spanish for...
Fighting chicken.
Fighting chicken. Oh, it's badass.
Hey, man, you want to come over and play G.I. Joe? Don't you remember I fucking hate you?
Oh, God.
That's a great movie.
That is a great movie.
So what is our draft this week?
So this week's draft. It is your draft. In a sense, it's your draft. Let me try to explain this. So the way we're going to put it is it's... You're not normal top in inventions ever. So what I mean by that is like you're not normal. You're unpopular.
You can't
ones,
pick
I guess.
The light bulb.
Yeah,
that's too,
the light bulb.
We
or
know
the
that's
printing
good.
Press or the cotton gin or
cars,
you know,
or planes.
One like something that's been right. Like it's just what we think has been the best inventions besides.
What's made your life easier and changed your life, but it hasn't been $1 million and it hasn't been 20,000 and it's not a car.
So are we doing a randomizer?
No, we'll start with you.
We'll start with you.
Way.
Yeah.
Okay. My number one was air conditioning. I thought that was just where we live. It gets really hot and humid in the summer. And if you've ever tried to sleep when it's 90 degrees and 8,000% humidity, you can't.
You turn a fan on.
We don't live in a jungle.
And just shovel the water around? What is that going to do? What do fans do when they blow hot air on you?
I don't know. Blow
I'm
hot
just
air
saying,
on you.
Could you not live with air conditioning?
I could.
I would have no choice. But I would probably sleep with a lot less blankets and clothes and.
Oh, I don't sleep with blankets anymore.
Rooms.
In the summer. I throw that crap.
I would probably just lay outside.
Really?
I don't know.
Oh, dude, no.
Sleep covered up.
I have
get
to sleep covered up.
I get moved around.
I have to sleep covered up too.
Yeah,
like because blankets protect you, and
from
you have
what?
To have them on.
They protect you from
the boogeyman.
What?
Stupid
the boogeyman. People touch you in the middle of the night.
Yeah, don't you read a book?
Speaking. I used to be afraid of that. I used to be afraid to keep sleep with my feet out under my blanket because I'm afraid something was going to touch
me. I can't sleep like this
because
I feel like I'm going to get stabbed in the throat. It just it's weird.
Or you're in a coffin already.
Yeah,
you're
I don't.
I can't sleep on my back at all.
I don't touch that. I don't lay on my back.
Air conditioner.
Air conditioner. Okay. Yeah.
Yep. Right. Mine is 2020 proved it to us. Very useful tool. The bidet. When we had the toilet paper shortage from COVID,
oh my god,
every
shit my
motherfucker
pants.
Was on Amazon ordering a bidet, shooting cold water up
I
their
didn't.
Ass. Really?
I didn't order a bidet.
I did.
Oh man, yeah,
I did absolutely, and I had one before that. Honestly,
let me clarify, I wasn't that asshole at the store either, buying like 17 freaking packages of toilet
and like
paper
selling it for $500 like the plywood guys
just
did.
Just going around with the trench coat, like, yo, man, I got some Charmin Extra Soft.
I tell you what,
to believe it or not, it crossed my mind to go into restaurants and shit and steal it out of there.
Did it really?
No, I mean, it crossed
they were
my
closed,
mind.
Weren't they?
I didn't do it, but it crossed my mind. I'm going to stop at a public restroom. I might just walk out with a couple rolls of toilet
might
paper.
Might just fucking roll it down.
Is that not a good idea?
If it someone doesn't say toilet paper is one of their best inventions, I'm going to be disappointed too.
Ryan would have said it if he was here.
So I get two?
Yep.
Yep, back to back.
My number one pick is going to be back scratcher.
Mm. Yeah.
Dude, the back scratcher is amazing.
Yeah. I use a corner of a wall.
I use anything. I think anything that uses a back scratcher.
You apparently don't own a back scratcher.
No, I just feel like I'm a bear when I'm on it.
I kind of do the bear wall thing too.
I do a back scratcher.
And I can reach my I can touch my hands on the back.
You've got built-in back scratchers.
You have 3 of them.
Yeah, well those motherfuckers are always upstairs and they never come down. Or if they do, my wife's like, "Your dad's hairy. Don't fucking touch him."
Rude.
Not even joking.
Yeah, eventually you kids are going to be hairy too. So, so back scratcher was my first. I'm going to say the toilet. In general.
Just
with the bidet or just the toilet?
No, just the toilet.
Just being
you
able
have to have
shit
the toilet to have the bidet.
I've shit on buckets and it's not
I've
that.
Shit on buckets
so you're
going to
put a bidet on a bucket?
No, I put a toilet seat on a bucket and take shit.
Right. So, but the vendor of the toilet, that you don't have to clean that bucket.
I've been to Boy Scout camp. They don't really have toilets per se. It's more of like a...
You don't think the toilet was a good invention?
I think it's a great invention.
I think it's a great invention. Then I just...
shut up.
Yeah. My kid sits on it fucking 5 hours a day.
Yeah, so do you.
Yeah. Well...
30 minutes.
Hour and 45, maybe.
Yeah. Legs fall asleep and shit.
Oh, isn't that the greatest feeling? It's like the stranger.
I
feel like Oscar Pistorius.
Hold on. Follow me here. If you've never sat on a toilet and let your legs to go numb, you've never known what it's like to be a paraplegic. Get up.
Oh,
stop it.
Come
on. You dumbass.
Like, I'm not even kidding.
I do know what it's like, though, because when I sleep on my side a lot, and my arm's always under my pillow, like holding my pillow like this. So my arm falls asleep a lot when I sleep. And
that is uncomfortable.
The one
though, when
time
you can't,
I rolled over and like your arm's fucking dead. And I literally lifted it up and it went right back down to my face and woke me up. Like completely woke me
Are
up.
Are you kidding me?
No.
That's hilarious. That's awesome.
My arm was dead. I mean,
oh yeah.
So
I've had that happen, falling asleep on the couch where like I have my hand around like one of the kids or the wife and I can't move it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's painful.
The toilet.
All right. I'm going to go with something more recent. I would say probably in the last 5 years, routers, you know, for Wi-Fi. They have a cool, neat feature in them now that, as a parent, is vital to shutting your kids' internet off so they can go to bed. All the kids have Xboxes in their room, and from my Netgear app on my phone, I can just shut the access to their Xbox, phone, and laptop off so they can go to bed. I mean, that to me is a huge invention.
Managed Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
I like it. I like it a lot.
Velcro. Velcro is very handy. I feel like it's very useful.
Give me
some
applications so that you use it in currently. Are you old man with the double Velcro shoes?
So I was organizing my garage the other
Grandpa
day.
Grandpa cruisers?
No, listen.
Is that what you call them?
Safety shoes. You leave them alone.
I call them Grandpa cruisers.
One day you'll wear them.
You're going to be
love,
on the fucking...
You'll love the Velcro.
You're going to be on South Beach, Miami wearing white fucking New Balance
Grandpa
Velcro
cruisers.
No, but I wrapped all my extension cords with Velcro. You know, it's good to keep them organized. It was handy. It could hang it up on the wall.
You know, if you're a true electrician,
electrical braid.
Yeah, electrical braid that shit, and you can hang it by it's got a built-in Velcro to it.
Well, since I'm not a true electrician, I'm never going to have an electrical braid. I'll just use Velcro.
Well, it's not hard to do, man.
No, it's a pain in the ass if you ever have to take it out of that braid and then put it back in the braid. It takes a long time, but... Not a long time if you're good at it. But anyway, so Velcro.
What's your next one?
Swiss Army knife. Also very handy if you ever go like camping and whatnot.
I love it. I think a Swiss Army knife was a great invention.
It's a great invention.
How many tools in it?
Yeah.
You know?
You've got everything you could ever possibly need.
And a toothpick.
And oh, God.
You've got a plier. So I was thinking, I'm like, oh, pliers are a great invention. I'm like, dude, fuck that. Swiss Army knife. You got a knife. You got a screwdriver. You got a bottle opener. You got a corkscrew.
Well, the only
got...
thing I could challenge that with would be like the Gerber. That does have pliers.
Like the multi-tool?
Gabe. Yeah. Well, it's a Swiss Army knife. Same concept. No. The multi-tool, we'll say then.
All right. Like, Swiss Army knife doesn't have, unless they make one, I don't know.
My grandfather worked at Pioneer.
Oh, yeah, Swiss Army knife, sorry.
I'm thinking of the multi-tool thing that sits in your pocket and it weighs you down.
See, my grandfather had the Swiss Army knife. He worked at Pioneer in Des Moines, and they issued everybody a little Swiss Army knife as a gift, and I tell you what, he used that toothpick all the time.
Yeah.
He passed away. I inherited it from him. So I have this Swiss Army
knife.
So I
use his toothpick?
No. But it's so so crazy how like those toothpicks.
That's a piece of beef jerky. How old is that?
After 30 years, that toothpick's like this big. Like he whittled it down after a while because it kept breaking.
Was it plastic?
Do you got anything else that he just maybe chewed on and he just wanted to keep or something, dude?
You got his retainer?
No, I'm good. My uncle's got his wedding ring.
His dentures?
That's a common. Oh,
I thought
gross.
You were going to say dentures.
No, he didn't have dentures, I don't believe.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, so Velcro and Swiss multi-tool.
Army, multi-tool, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All
right. Mine's going to go a little towards the golf season, and I'm going to go with the invention of forged combo clubs. So back in the day when you used to have a cast iron, you know, there was no
rattled the shit out of your
yeah,
hand.
Exactly. And now that with these forged cavity backs that they have a two piece, they're hollow. They've got more spring, more bounce, lighter weight, but more toe weight, more heel weight. Just flies your ball a lot better. Like I've taken some of the old school clubs out and I'm like good 50, 60 yards shorter than when I actually hit.
Yeah, there's a significant difference
so you think
when you
that's
buy
the best invention.
Well, if you're a golfer, I'm an avid golfer.
When you buy the better clubs, though, I've noticed it because I've had dog shit clubs and then I've gotten really good clubs, and you do notice a difference in your game. It does hit it further and not straighter. That's still operator error. But
and I think when I first started, I had woods like fairway woods.
Like Ryan, dude, remember that time we went golfing and Ryan had the woods and I'm like,
he still does.
My insert on my driver actually fucking broke out and it was wood and I had to glue it back in and hammer it in with a nail.
The sound of woods I think is better than I like the sound of woods on the golf ball.
Sound of wood.
Well, come on, like you baseball too, like that, the crack of the bat, it's a good sound. Yeah, kind of like celery breaking
in the face or
just sound the baseball makes as it hits my orbital bone, it just shatters my face.
I was talking the wood.
Oh.
The wood. All right.
So
Michael?
I got two.
Last two, right?
No, this is my third and fourth.
Oh, okay.
For my third, condoms.
That's very fair.
Not everybody wants to have kids.
That's very fair.
Or not ready to at the time.
Are you going to include like all contraceptives in that or just the condom?
Well, I'm just going to say
the condom. Just the condom. That's a very good one because you can use it as a water sack if nothing else fails. go out in the woods. You didn't see that? Okay, so there was this episode of
Survivor Man?
Yeah, something like that. I'm telling you.
Bear Grylls.
They make the best thing to hold water in, and he's got like four condoms and he just fills it with water.
Hold on. I've seen the Navy SEALs in the movie fucking wrap condoms over their guns so they don't get water in their barrels, but I've never seen
good
anybody
invention, Mike. The condom's
fill a
good
condom
invention.
Up with fucking water.
Why does this water taste weird?
You don't use the lube ones, probably. I don't know.
The spermicidal gel?
Spermicidal.
Can you imagine
the icy hot?
Hey, did you guys get the icy hot ones? Yeah,
I bought a little bottle of spermicidal lube. You bought spermicidal lube?
Do you think it matters if it's ribbed or not?
For her pleasure.
Okay, so the condom's a good invention.
Condoms is a great invention.
It's a great invention.
So I had the back scratcher, the toilet, the condoms. I'm going to say adjustable beds.
I don't understand the reference. I've never had an adjustable bed.
Until you have an adjustable bed that you can raise the head and feet, that is a game changer, best invention ever.
I think Candace and I are going towards that here soon.
One.
Do you really?
Yeah, we don't have one.
Is it like...
We don't have one where I can adjust my side,
sleep
she
number.
Can adjust her side. We have I think it's a...
like a hospital bed that goes
so
up
like,
and down.
So hold on. So you guys have to go up together?
Yes.
And your feet have to go up together, so it's not split in the middle.
No.
Do you guys have the ones where it controls like your stiffness and like softness?
No.
I've seen those now that have like the stiffness and softness. You can adjust those, but also have like hot and cold.
Yeah, dude, that would be perfect for me.
I would have
cold. Sleep cold.
I got to sleep cold too.
Maybe then I'd want blankets.
But, so air conditioning is a great invention then for you.
So no, we have one that I can't even remember the brand of it.
It doesn't matter.
We were talked out of a Tempur-Pedic. We were at Ashley Furniture, looked at a Tempur-Pedic in the store.
You're at Ashley's Furniture Store?
And the store manager says, the store manager, Ashley, the store manager said, he's like, I'd probably lose my job for this, but I can't remember what brand it was, but go lay in that one. He says, I switch everybody to this and it's cheaper.
Really?
Yeah.
Good.
We've always done memory foam, but I tell you what, you sleep
that's
in the same.
A lot of them are.
Yeah, but you sleep in the same spot for fucking 10 years. You get a dent.
Yeah. No adjustable bed.
I don't know. Can you flip those memory foam ones, or doesn't that work that way?
I don't know.
Well, you know, Candace, the other night I laid down on her side, and it was definitely more elevated than mine. I was like, "Yours is soft as shit." Mine
she goes, "Lazy, yours it falls."
She goes, "I'm not laying on your side." She's like, "We'll just rotate the bed." And
I'm
like,
just kidding.
Do you not understand how rotate works? Like, you're gonna get my side.
Flip it over if you can. I don't know how it works. I've never had a Tempur-Pedic, but.
I don't think you can flip this one over.
You can't flip them over.
Call me old school, but I like a mattress you can flip over when it gets worn on the one side.
Or if you piss on one side.
Most mattresses you can't, though.
Flip over?
Piss on one side?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The bottom's different.
The old school 80s and 90s mattresses weren't.
No, but those also weighed retro. About fucking a million pounds.
Oh, yeah, dude. You grab by the handles and just rip the handles off.
Why did everything weigh so much back then? Tube TVs, mattresses.
I mean, technology, man.
People can't steal. People don't steal.
I mean, look at fucking computers. You know, we got laptops now that weigh less than a pound. And, you know, back in
like
the day.
Like cell phones.
Back in the day. They had big... The first portable laptop had a fucking handle on it. And you had to, like, wheel it around on wheels.
That and, like, tables, even desks.
Yeah.
I mean,
everything's gotten
better,
more streamlined. But
well, when we moved in here, we still had two box TVs from the 90s, like the big 60-inch projection or 65-inch projections.
You brought them here?
Fuck no, man. We burnt the shit out of those. Yeah, but say. Like, it took a country, fucking three or four people to pick that shit up. Yeah, or the old CRT monitors and stuff like that on computers. Those were crazy.
Oh, yeah, dude.
All right, my turn.
Yeah.
I am gonna have to say. A company and their inventions in whole, Apple. When Apple created the Macintosh computer, it led to a whole new realm of technology. I'm an iPhone guy. I'm an Apple person.
That's awfully light bulby.
No,
it's awfully light bulby.
Henry shaking
you,
his fucking head.
Awfully light bulb. I'm just going to take the entire universe.
I literally took the fucking
invention.
Toilet and a condom. And you're like, Apple.
Man.
That's pretty light.
Yeah,
bulb-y.
Way to go, buddy.
That's about as light bulby as Dave's.
I was really I was thinking Apple phone.
That was
like
not light bulby.
Yeah,
really?
That's a light bulb.
All right, fuck.
That's just too general.
Thanks, Thomas Edison.
You could have said maybe like the iPhone 11 or something like that.
The light bulb filament, Thomas Edison.
Yeah, and Ben Franklin.
Benjamin Franklin.
God, what
Philadelphia.
Constitution.
Struggling here then, because that was pretty much going to be AirPods were going to be my next one.
Well, pick that one for this one.
Like, I'm serious.
How are you going to pick all of Apple things and then pick AirPods?
Technology has
how
like,
are you going to sit there and say, oh, no, light bulbs or cotton gins?
No, technology has advanced our lives so much, and I feel like
apparently not. You can't think of anything that's helped your life.
No, I have.
The Apple company? I get it, but like
AirPods? I mean, like, I would be lost without my iPad and
you know
keyboard.
What? Shout out to Aldi's. You guys have invented really good food. Thank you.
You know what I think? I think you should pick the fucking grabber.
The grabber.
Yeah.
What's that?
Do you know
the thing that you can pull the thing and grab
shit up with?
Oh,
that's
no.
a great invention.
Never. You could have said like the Xbox or something, dude, and I'd have been like, okay, cool, but like, no. Apple. Everything under that umbrella.
I'm serious. Like, I literally just want the iPad. Like the iPad.
Okay.
iPad.
Okay. iPad. Cool. Yeah. Move on.
Yeah.
Dave. Okay.
Someone just fell.
Bring us back after this one.
Okay. I had a list here. Sorry.
A lisp?
A list. batteries. Any kind of battery. The ability to...
And what about that is not light bulby?
What
fuck
do you mean?
Me running.
That's
air
a battery.
Conditioner I just... and battery. And I'm sitting here taking the toilet and the fucking condoms. And the
being
back
able to
scratcher.
Store. Being able to store. So I guess soap is out too then, huh? Soap, the ability to clean your fucking asshole so you don't get bubonic plague?
No, that's a good one. That's
okay,
not light bulby at all.
Soap.
Clean bubonic plague.
You get that from not cleaning yourself?
Is that what it was?
I'm pretty sure soap cured the bubonic plague. I'm not a history guy, but I'm pretty sure that...
Henry, you seem pretty smart back there, college educated man.
Well, that's me.
No, no answer for that one.
All right, then my fifth one's going to be lasagna. The best invention because lasagna is an amazing food and you can do so much with it.
Okay.
You guys laugh.
Okay.
You guys laugh.
Okay.
I put
that's
some
your
thought
last
in
one.
This. These are great inventions,
all
folks.
All right. So then this one, okay. So I said iPad. You guys are going to say this one's fucking light bulby. GPS. And I'm going to give you a perfect example of why GPS has changed everybody's life.
Nobody knows how to read a map?
Yeah.
Well, no. But
that's
the
a good
thing.
One, though.
But that's the thing. Like, Candace and I, we went on our honeymoon, and it was not a big one. We didn't have a ton of money. We went to the East Coast.
But we had a map.
But no, we printed everything off on MapQuest. So if we wanted to go somewhere, we literally had pages of fucking directions.
Turn left on this, honey. I think we passed this.
And here's the deal. If you got off on the wrong exit,
you were fucked.
MapQuest and those papers weren't going to tell you to reroute. And it wasn't going to tell you where to go.
But a good old fashioned map would.
No, it wouldn't. Like, I couldn't fucking read a map. But GPS has
done
that.
How do you not know how to
that.
Follow lines?
Dude, I'm telling you, when you get off in the East Coast and you get off at a fucking toll booth and you got to get back on at another
I mean, you
toll
might need
booth.
To get a city map. Like, if you're in New York City, I imagine their maps are the size of, like,
no.
one of the boroughs, like, the size of our Iowa map.
I'm going to say GPS. And I even had...
GPS is a good one, though.
I even had a coworker today that she admitted, I asked her, I said, you know, I'm struggling on my last one. And I go, what is the best?
I'll see you at help?
I asked her. I said, what do you think the best invention
can't
was?
Think.
I didn't even talk to anybody.
Can't think.
About
yeah,
it.
I talked to myself.
I told her what mine was, and she goes, I couldn't live without my Garmin back
said,
in the day.
Apple. That's too light, Bobby.
She, no, not she only said, her, she said Apple, her Garmin.
Apple company, but I mean apples, like as really? A fruit,
well,
too.
She had a great story about it because she actually used to travel 25 years ago when like the GPS was first invented with Garmin, and she said she was actually in Boston, Massachusetts, which, if you've been there, is 100 million one-way streets. And 2-foot-high curbs, and if you go down the wrong one, you're fucked. And it's like trying to find a needle in a haystack to get out of there. Well, she was trying to go to the airport the next morning, and she was walking into her hotel room, and she pulled her Garmin out of her car, and the Garmin dropped on the ground, and the screen cracked, and she's like, I'm not going to be able to get to the airport. And so they had the hotel shuttle. She got up early enough that the shuttle guy actually drove to the airport, and she followed him to the airport so she can get there.
I'm a big fucking tip.
But GPS is actually relevant for you too. Like if you get called in emergencies, you guys know where it's at because of GPS too. So it is very handy.
I mean, we get known for a few things. We get the address sent to us, so we can pull it up in like Google Maps or iPhone Maps, which is not always 100% accurate.
No, but it's within certain.
But we also use a thing called I'm Responding that has a map. And the latest, the update about 6 months ago, it was an update where it shows a dot where the caller called from, so and also correlates where the address is. So, like,
so you guys actually get when somebody calls in to like the fire, the EMS, whatever it is, you guys get a ping from where that phone call was made.
Yeah, as long as they, I don't know if they have to have location settings on their phone.
Sure,
but when they call 911, so if like say you called 911 here,
yeah,
it would show it would have a IAR for I am responding.
Yeah,
a
dot.
Yeah.
Or pin
over the house for the address,
yeah.
But it would also have where the caller was, and then if we have people that respond, say personal vehicle, they can select go to scene, and it'll navigate them to where if I checked my map, I can see when they're going to be there, and it'll also show their vehicle there.
No
yeah.
shit.
Yeah.
So GPS is very that's a very good one, I think, because that's revolutionized.
But
our
I was on the fence.
We have 100%. Have still been, you need to know where you're going.
Absolutely.
Do not rely on GPS all the time.
Absolutely. But
look at the map and
it gives
the truck.
You a closer idea than having to necessarily get it. Cause you could go down a level B road really quick and get
now
screwed
for
over.
Myself
so.
And like my assistant chief.
Yeah.
He's a well pump guy. I'm in communications. We're around our communities and fire districts.
So
lot.
You know where it's
so
at.
If someone says this road, I typically know it. Or if I hear a name, I know exactly where it is.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yep.
Where there's other people on our departments, like
need the GPS. Need the GPS. Yeah.
So, GPS is important. Yeah, I still have a Garmin. I bet the maps are way outdated on it. TomTom was another big one.
Yeah. Oh,
then.
TomTom. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So.
Yep.
Yep. Get the Navy out.
That's my last one. Yeah. GPS.
Took you. I don't even know what your third and fourth one were. Probably like Apple and.
One was the iPad.
What was the iPad?
The Apple iPad, and then everything else that Apple made.
It was a GPS.
And then the AirPods, which also was made by Apple.
No,
so.
AirPods,
and
you didn't admit
bidet
that.
And
bidet.
So,
yeah.
My last pick.
Sir, not strong. Just finish week.
My last pick, and to finish out the draft, is something that saved the world. Something that helped invent ice cream.
Oh, Jesus. I thought you were going to go with COVID shot for a second.
No, the COVID shot didn't save the fucking world. Something that helped invent ice cream. If it wasn't for this product, ice cream would have never been made.
Salt?
Beer.
What?
Yeah.
Hold on. Beer made ice cream?
Beer, no. If it wasn't for the creation of beer, ice cream would have never been invented.
Really?
At that time. Yep.
Really?
Look it up.
No shit.
There was a documentary on Discovery Channel, How Beer Saved the World.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Hmm.
How beer saved the world.
Absolutely. I do love a good ice cream.
I like a good documentary.
Oh, yeah, good documentary. Yeah. Real big documentary fan.
It lowers your cholesterol.
Documentaries do?
No. Ice cream does.
They might.
The way Richter does it.
No,
probably
not
like,
ice cream. Beer.
Yeah, ice cream. I eat that chip on the buckets.
Hey, I don't drink beer.
Just beer ice cream.
When it's drank in the right spurts and everything, beer lowers your cholesterol.
Not like mass consumptions.
Not mass consumptions. Any copious amounts obviously doesn't lower your cholesterol. It makes you hydrated while you drink it, and then you're dehydrated the next morning.
Mm. Well, what's the
catch 22?
Yeah, dude. How beer saved the world. Beer is...
I'll tell you here in a bit. Okay. This is not appropriate for this.
Beer is my last pick to end that draft. That's a good draft. It was kind of a tough draft because I
It was.
When you put...
I struggled.
When you put, like, nothing like light bulb-ish yeah. or airplane-ish, I would say, or air conditioner-ish. But anyways...
Come on. That was a good one.
I was honestly, like... I didn't want to go light bulb. I didn't want to go airplane car. I thought the Tesla coil was a good one, but it was too old. I wasn't going to put it in there, but I think the Tesla coil has so many applications.
Geometry.
I think that's a great invention by coil? Jesus.
Algebra.
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 The Bible. Anyway. No, I thought GPS was a solid last one, man.
What?
I thought GPS
was
a solid
last one. No, what did you say before that?
The Bible. That's what Notzi said. He messaged me.
Oh, that's
people didn't invent the Bible. No, it's either
no,
wrote it.
No, it was additional. It was, hey, did you guys get my OJ thing earlier?
Perfect.
Oh, yeah, OJ. He admitted.
He admitted. He confessed on his deathbed.
So he's not the greatest to ever do it anymore. Well, I guess he still could be.
Did you see who was?
Dude, he fucking wrote a book that said, hey, if I ever did it, this is how I would have done it.
Yeah, like, I understand.
Yeah, of course he did it.
But listen,
you guys, I don't care.
See, look at that. Did you see that?
Stop. You guys act like you're surprised.
No, did you
oh
see
oh, my God. OJ actually did kill it. No
hey,
shit.
Hey,
so did Ray Lewis.
Did you read
yeah,
it?
I don't care.
Did you read it?
I don't care.
Look.
I know. I don't care, dude. Yeah.
Dave,
that's awesome.
Dave doesn't care that Ray Lewis killed someone and then won a Super Bowl.
People kill people all the time. I feel like that.
They have
fall guys.
And they normally are in jail.
Yeah, I know. I'm not saying he doesn't deserve to be
what
in jail.
Did I see
but
who did what?
They got acquitted. It's just...
I said, so he's not the best to ever do.
Notes, he says, don't click the link if Josh sends it to you.
Yeah, that's how you get. That's how you get viruses.
Yeah, viruses and stuff.
That's, dude, we had my buddy Jimmy.
Henry, you guys, are you on your phone right now? All right, I'm going to send you this link.
You guys have met Jimmy. Obviously, you have.
Yeah.
In our fantasy group chat, Riley would always make me laugh so hard because, like, Jimmy, we would get this mass message from Jimmy, and he got hacked on Facebook. And literally within an instant, Riley would comment back. It's like, Jimmy, you're not supposed to click on the pop-up ads in porn.
It's not a virus, Henry.
Oh, dude, it was so funny. And I said, Jimmy goes, I don't. And Riley goes, dude, I watch a lot of porn and I don't get the viruses, so you must be clicking on
bruh. That's perfect. We probably shouldn't put Riley's shit out there like that.
That he watches porn?
Watching a lot of porn.
Riley and Bowden watches a lot of porn.
Ooh.
Last name too.
Can we change his
he lives in Champaign, Illinois.
Can we change his fantasy name? To I like porn.
I watch porn.
Yeah, do something like that.
Big
can
porn,
you change that as the
fan.
Commissioner?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Let's do that this year. And then lock it so he can't fucking change it.
I don't know if I could lock it.
Yeah, that'd
I'm
be
sure
awesome.
I could.
Don't click the link, Notzi.
Don't click the
link. Yeah. I'm going to send it out. We're going to put a link in the podcast description here.
Podcast?
Podcast description.
Podcast.
For what?
The OJ. Confession.
Oh.
On his deathbed.
Yeah, he did it.
We lost a good one, Juice. We'll see
we
you in the next one.
We didn't lose a good one. We lost someone that...
A hell of an athlete. Hell of a ball player guy.
Yeah.
Kind of shithole person, but hell of a ball player.
Someone said we lost the best to ever do it, and I heard he was really good at football.
Jesus.
Oh, his family's going to sue somebody.
Sometimes dark humor is good.
It is.
All right, so that's the draft. We will put it up on social media here within the next few days, probably Monday. Go ahead and give us a vote on who you think did the best.
I don't expect much, guys.
Yeah, we don't expect much out of that.
So. No.
Not for me. Not for me.
Because three of your
not
fucking things were the
not
iPad.
Not for me.
Apple as a whole and Apple AirPods. I don't care. Air conditioner is a great one.
And if you haven't voted on it yet, we have not closed the voting. Go ahead and vote on the top five sodas.
Oh, yeah. Coca-Cola is not one of them.
Magic Mike. Coca-Cola was not one of them. What about
Coca-Cola
McDonald's spiced. Coke?
Kyle, you know better than that.
Coca-Cola. What?
He just puked in his mouth.
I'm pretty sure Dave probably voted for Mike because he had Dr. Pepper.
Oh, yeah, true.
I didn't vote yet. I need to go and decide because there's a couple of them that
have
I like.
Have you even looked at it yet?
Yeah, someone
did
had
you
Surge
watch
on
the
there.
Episode?
I had Surge.
Is that Surge? Yeah, okay.
Did you watch the episode?
Parts of it, yeah.
Yeah, you didn't grow up in the 90s without saying Surge.
Surge was the shit.
Surge.
Josh is over here going, Fresco.
Fresca.
Squirt.
Fresca Squirt. High C Orange.
High C Orange is not a soda.
Motherfucker, it's a juice.
It's a juice.
And it's carbonated.
It's not carbonated.
What is the definition of pop and soda?
Not high C orange.
Carbonation.
The first comment we got on social media was that is not a soda.
I am
by a guy
you
who already
right
told
now,
me it wasn't a soda.
High C is not carbonated. It tastes like Powerade.
It is fucking carbonated there.
Yeah, you were drinking Fanta, you fucking idiot. That's orange Fanta, not orange high C.
You pop the top.
No. I don't know.
You might get a little carbonation. No, you might get a little carbonation because it's one machine.
Yeah.
But it doesn't come from the high C orange.
It's
high C orange,
high C
is
orange
juice.
Is juice.
All right, high C orange people.
That's like saying freaking, what was the one?
V8
with the,
is a Michael.
Somebody says, what the fuck? Government name? Laugh out loud. Not soda. Mike, you told me last week, 2 weeks ago, it was not soda. I get it. Stein has told me, he's like, it's not soda. He just commented.
It's not soda.
It's
not
soda.
It's juice.
Dummy.
I see orange.
It's like Powerade or vitamin water.
Put your phone down. Juice. Listen to this.
It's not carbonated juice.
Yeah, that's good. Bob Sapp.
Bob Sapp. Rest in peace.
Bob
Sapp. Oh, yeah, dude. That is sad. Rest in peace, Bob Sapp.
Yeah.
You ever watch? He was a UFC fighter and then a linebacker.
That's not Bob Sapp, though. Bob Sapp's really alive.
Yeah.
Bob Saget.
No, that guy's dead.
That guy is?
Yeah. So is Bob Saget.
Yeah. Is that Michael Clark Duncan?
So is Danny Tanner.
He's passed.
Danny Tanner's gone.
Yeah.
Yeah,
RIP, Bob Sapp.
Anyways, we've digressed. That's going to be a blooper reel. Thank you for joining us tonight. Look forward to us here in a couple weeks and as we get back going and hopefully keep on keeping on. So thanks for watching, and we will be dropping this episode on Amazon Music, Spotify, Podbean, iHeartRadio. And in the near future here. And
still waiting for Apple.
Still waiting for Apple.
Well, fuck you. Fuck Apple. I like your shit, Apple, and you can't fucking approve our podcast. What the fuck?
Yeah, well, I'll cut that part where you're saying I like it and send it to him.
Tim Cook.
Maybe we should reapply.
Quit worrying about movies.
And go hit up our sponsors, Vans Liquor Store, Deary Nissan of Dubuque, Shank at Golf. And yeah, go hit them up. District 20 t-shirts.
Enjoy the Masters.
Enjoy
the Masters. It's going to be a fun weekend for golf and for just
and
overall weekend weather around here too.
If you haven't, people that participated in our men's and women's NCAA challenge, you got to message us to get your prizes. If you place first, second, or third in each of the brackets, we posted it out there on our social media pages. So you've got to message us on there with your address. And we'll get back with you.
Yeah, make sure you put that address to a public post so everybody knows.
Personal DM.
Yeah, or just if you don't want to, don't send it to us, then we don't have to send a prize. I mean, if they don't send us their address, we don't have
hot
to send
dogs,
shit.
Jackie, hot dogs.
All right, on that
you're
note,
get a big check.
See you later.
Big check.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.